Welcome to this video guide, intended for use alongside the third lesson in a series of resources on the PCR process. This third video will guide you in using gel electrophoresis to analyse the DNA fragments that were amplified using PCR in lesson 2. For this lesson, you will need PV92 homozygous and heterozygous control samples, DNA loading dye, TAE solution. Note that in your experiment, this will have been pre-prepared at a 1x concentration. Begin with the PCR sample that was prepared in lesson 2 and has now been through the PCR process, resulting in multiple copies of your original DNA sample fragment. Take the loading dye from the icebox. Add 10 microliters of the loading dye to your PCR tube that contains your DNA. Discard the pipette tip and then gently mix the contents of the PCR tube. Next, you will need to create an agarose gel. This may have been done for you, and if so, you can skip to a later point in the video. Take your 1x TAE buffer and mix it with some agar powder. In this example, 2 grams of agar has been used with 200 milliliters of TAE 1x buffer solution. To prepare the agarose gel, this mixture will need to be boiled. Therefore, in order to minimize evaporation of TAE during this process, wrap cling film over the top of the conical flask twice and pierce with a sharp object. The mixture is now ready to be placed into a microwave. Put it in the microwave for 1 minute and at the end of the minute, check to see whether the mixture has become transparent. If it has not, then put it back in the microwave for another minute and continue this process until it has. Note that the conical flask can get hot during this process, and something may be needed to protect your hands from the heat. When the agarose mixture seems to be transparent, it may be useful to hold the mixture up to a light to double check this. The mixture needs to be fully transparent before moving on to the next stage. When this is complete, you will need to create the agarose gel casting tray. Assemble the casting tray, making sure that the rubber seals on it are tight. When the casting tray is assembled, take the sample comb and place it across the tray within 2 centimeters from the end. If you want to increase the number of samples that are run on one gel, you can also place a sample comb in the middle of the tray to create more wells. Your casting tray is now ready to have the agarose gel mixture poured into it. Note that the agarose needs to have cooled to 60 degrees Celsius before this can happen. Leave the gel to cool and solidify for 10 to 20 minutes. It will be translucent when ready to use. When the agarose gel has set, remove the sample comb from the gel. This should have created wells in the gel where your DNA samples will be placed later on. The next stage of the experiment will use the electrophoresis equipment. Remove the rubber sides from the casting tray containing your agarose gel and place it onto the platform in the gel box, making sure that the sample wells are at the cathode or black end of the base. Next, pour approximately 275 milliliters of your TAE buffer into the electrophoresis chamber until it just covers the wells in the gel. The gel is now ready to start having DNA samples loaded into it. The controlled DNA samples will first be loaded into the wells. Make sure that the pipette is set to 10 microliters when putting in the controlled DNA samples. To ensure that there is no cross-contamination, discard the pipette tip and swap it for a new one between every sample. Be sure to add each DNA sample to a new well every time so that the different samples do not get mixed. Continue to add 10 microliters of each controlled DNA sample and then 20 microliters of each student DNA sample to the wells in the gel. When every DNA sample has been added, place the lid on the gel box and attach the leads to the power supply. The lid will only attach to the base in one orientation, red to red and black to black. Set the power supply to 100 volts and let the electrophoresis run for 30 minutes. You should see bubbles moving inside the gel box as a result of the current being passed through. During the electrophoresis process, your DNA samples will separate along the agarose gel based on their size. Shorter strands of DNA will move along the gel more than the longer ones. This results in different amounts of separation for different samples of DNA. When the electrophoresis is complete, turn off the power supply and remove the lid from the gel box. Carefully remove the gel tray containing the gel from the gel box. Take care when removing the gel tray, as the gel will be slippery. Using your thumb, nudge the gel from the gel tray, allowing it to slide into your plastic staining tray. Your gel is now ready to be stained. Staining the gel will reveal the strands of DNA on the gel and allow you to interpret your results. This is the end of Lesson 3. This resource was created at the University of Bath by two natural sciences students, Ben Evans and Ella Baskerville.